Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Have you ever wondered why a car won't go until you push the gas pedal? Or why a kicked soccer ball will keep rolling all the way down the field unless a defender stops it? Each of these events are governed by a fundamental law of nature known as Newton's first law. If you remember from a few lessons back, Isaac Newton spent his entire career studying forces and motion, and much of the physics we know today is based on what he discovered. His three fundamental laws of motion were some of his most important contributions, and we'll look at the first one in detail today. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define Newton's first law and explain the concept of inertia, differentiate between balanced and unbalanced forces and explain how they relate to an object's motion, and apply Newton's first law to real-life situations, predicting the behavior of objects in various scenarios. Newton's first law, sometimes called the law of inertia, is very straightforward. An object will continue its current motion unless a force acts to change it. This means that stationary objects, like these books sitting on the table, will simply remain stationary. Unless, of course, you put a force on them to knock them off. Moving objects, like this tennis ball, will keep moving until a force from your opponent's racket makes it change directions. We said that Newton's first law is sometimes called the law of inertia. So, what exactly is inertia? Simply put, it's the tendency of an object to keep doing whatever it's doing. Inertia causes objects that are sitting still to keep sitting still, and objects that are moving to keep moving. A force is required if we want to overcome the inertia of an object and make a change to its motion. We said just a moment ago that these books would remain stationary due to inertia. We could have also said that they remain stationary because the forces acting on them are balanced. What forces do you think are currently acting on these books? They aren't even moving. Are any forces acting on them? I can think of at least one force that is always acting on every object on Earth. What is it? Gravity! And of course, the table itself is supplying an upward force that keeps the books from falling to the floor. These two forces are balanced, so no change occurs to the motion of the books. However, if an additional force is added that disrupts this balance, the books could come crashing to the ground. So, a stationary object will only begin moving in the presence of an unbalanced force. Otherwise, it is content to just keep sitting there. But what about moving objects? The idea of inertia would imply that a kicked soccer ball should keep rolling forever. But it clearly does not. Moving objects will only continue moving if no unbalanced forces act to stop them. What forces could possibly be at work here to stop the soccer ball? The most likely culprit is friction from both the ground and the air. As the soccer ball rolls, friction between the ground and ball and between the ball and the air works to slow its roll, eventually bringing it to a stop. Anytime you see a moving object come to a stop, seemingly on its own, friction is likely to blame. Inertia alone would keep the object moving indefinitely, but with no forward force to counteract friction, the forces become unbalanced and motion ceases. This is why when driving a car, you must constantly push on the gas pedal. If not for friction, you could push one time to accelerate, and then the car would just keep moving on its own. That would save a lot of effort, and gas. But as we discussed in a previous lesson, we do not live in a world that is ever free of friction. Remember that only unbalanced forces can change motion. This includes initiating motion for stationary objects and slowing down or stopping the motion of moving objects. If all forces remain balanced, things will simply remain as they are. That's inertia! To think about how Newton's first law affects the world around you, let's imagine a car with a load of unsecured cargo on the top. Right now, both the car and the crate have inertia in the forward direction. But what if the car comes to a sudden stop? Will the crate on top stop too? Probably not. Its inertia will carry it forward, causing it to fly off the roof and land on the road in front of the car. So, Newton's first law of motion will cause unsecured cargo to come flying off of the car in the event of a sudden stop. What about things inside the car, including you? As your car is barreling down the highway, it has inertia, and so do you as a passenger. If the car suddenly has to stop, will you stop as well? The simple answer is that your inertia will keep carrying you forward until something stops you. The best case scenario is that you are wearing a seatbelt, which is specifically engineered to stop you in the most gentle manner possible. If you have chosen to forgo the seatbelt, your next stop is likely the dashboard, which won't be nearly as gentle. So consider Newton's first law to be a good reminder every time you get in the car. Buckle up or face inertia's consequences. Now, let's try some examples, and you can practice using what you know about inertia and Newton's first law to make predictions. Here's your first one. A hockey puck is hit on a smooth ice rink. Assuming that the friction of the ice is low enough to be ignored, what will happen to the puck? Pause the video and make your prediction in your notes. What do you think? Because the puck has inertia, it will continue moving until a force stops it, perhaps the wall of the rink on the other end, or the net of the goal. In reality, the ice has a little bit of friction, which will slow the puck down. But ice is one of the lowest friction surfaces we have on Earth, and it probably won't exert enough force to completely overcome the puck's inertia before it reaches the other end of the rink. Let's try another one. After leaving the drive-thru, you absent-mindedly set your coffee cup on the dashboard. When your car accelerates to pull back onto the street, what is likely to happen to your coffee cup? Pause and make your prediction. While you were sitting still, the coffee cup's inertia was holding it in place. A force was required to make it move. Whereas the car will receive a force in the form of the engine, the coffee cup will not. The only relevant force acting on it will be the friction between the dashboard and the cup. But if you accelerate quickly, that friction will no longer be enough. As you accelerate forward, the cup's inertia will work to keep it in the same position in space, which will now be behind the dashboard and likely in your lap. In other words, I hope you weren't planning to drink that coffee because you will more likely be wearing it. Okay, last one. Imagine now that we're riding in a moving train, and you decide to toss a ball straight up into the air. Will the ball return to your hands, or will it appear to be pulled backward as you move forward without it? Make your prediction now. Remember that both you and the ball have forward inertia when the ball is thrown, so the ball will continue its forward motion even when not in your hands, and will therefore meet your hands right where they are when it comes back down. As we went through the lesson today, we saw how Newton's first law and inertia describe the tendency of objects to continue whatever motion they currently have, unless acted on by an unbalanced force. Remember that only unbalanced forces can change motion. Next time, we'll continue to explore Newton's laws by taking a closer look at his second law, which describes the relationship of mass and inertia. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.